Good afternoon. I'm Adrienne Banker. The long battle over gay marriage is again before California Supreme Court. The justices are considering a legal challenge to Proposition 8, the constitutional amendment banning gay marriage. As legal heavyweights from both sides make their pitch, activists are taking their case to the streets. It's all happening at a San Francisco courthouse. KCRA3's David Bienick is there with the latest on the case. Good afternoon, David.
Adrienne, good afternoon from San Francisco. Hundreds of people from both sides of the issue are gathered, not only here in front of the California State Supreme Court on the other side of these news trucks, but also over here in front of San Francisco City Hall. Meanwhile, inside at the hearing of the California Supreme Court, it has been going on since around 9 o'clock this morning. These are the same seven justices who last year ruled by 4-3 to make same-sex marriage legal in California. But now, as one of the justices said this morning, the issues facing the court are very different. The basic issue is whether Proposition 8, approved by voters last November, was such a big change to the California Constitution that it shouldn't have been done through the regular initiative process.
What Proposition 8 does, and what it make it contend, is that this is a case which, for the first time, a ballot initiative has been used to take away a fundamental right from a suspect class.
We have heard an enormous amount by very able counsel about individual rights and suspect classifications. Those are very important topics. What we did not hear a lot from the other side is this inalienable right of the people of California, whether wisely or no, to change the Constitution.
Yes.
Now, among the hundreds of people that are protesting here in San Francisco today are about 200 students from American River College in Sacramento. They tell us that they came down on three buses this morning. They support Proposition 8. In other words, they oppose same-sex marriage. Now, this morning's debate inside the hearing has been at times very lively. The judges have been joking at times with the lawyers. Some of the most intense questioning, however, has come from Justice Joyce Kennard. She was part of that majority that last year voted in favor of legalizing same-sex marriage, but she was the justice who said this morning that now that we're dealing with a constitutional amendment, the issue is completely different. So she could end up being the swing vote on the California Supreme Court that upholds Proposition 8 and makes same-sex marriage once again illegal in the state of California. We're expecting both lawyers from both sides come out after the hearing concludes and to give us their comments. The justices then will have 90 days or about 3 months to come up with their ruling. Live in San Francisco, David Bienick, KCRA3 reports.
Thank you, David, for reporting for us. You'll stay on that story. Meanwhile, we go inside the courtroom, and right now you are looking live inside the California hall there. We've got people contending over Proposition 8, should it be overturned. The justices here will have 90 days to make a decision and make a ruling there, but let's listen in for just a moment.
Again, Justice Kennard indicated in her concurring opinion in the marriage cases, our framers well understood.
As I pointed out earlier, I think the problem that a lot of people are the failure on the number of some people to see a distinction between what I said in my concurring opinion in the marriage cases and this particular case, there is quite a difference. In the marriage cases, this court was simply asked to do what it usually does, interpret a statutory provision in the light of a constitutional provision. As we all know, and I won't belabor all the cases that have said so, because this has been articulated by counsel, and I think Mr. Starr has articulated that, we have a body of case law that has talked about amendment / revision. And here we are dealing with the power of the people, an inalienable right to amend the Constitution as the people desire. This is what the people have done here. So I don't see that because I said what I said, and I'm still with what I said in my concurring opinion in the marriage cases, I stand by it. But this case is...
You're listening to Justice Joyce Kennard. She is one of the four justices who actually legalized gay and lesbian marriages before the decision to pass Prop 8 was passed back in November. And she has been quoted as saying that there are two issues here, the inalienable right to marry and the right of the people to change the Constitution as they see fit. So she's considered one of the swing votes. It is yet to be seen whether or not she will overturn the ruling of Proposition 8. And again, the Supreme Court hearing arguments on three major initiatives here. Prop 8, if it's invalid or not, because it constitutes a revision of rather than an amendment to the California Constitution. The second challenge involves a claim that Prop 8 violates the separation of powers doctrine under the California Constitution. And the third deals with what happens to the nearly 20,000 same-sex couples married before Prop 8 passes. That only becomes an issue if indeed Prop 8 remains in effect, and it would turn on judges' interpretation of a few words in the initiative itself.
And that sentence reads, telling the voters, your yes vote on Proposition 8 means that only marriage between a man and a woman will be valid or recognized in California, regardless of when or where performed.
It is not a clear statement that the law was intended to invalidate marriages entered into prior to the enactment of the measure.
And according to the San Francisco Chronicle, Kennard, that was Justice Kennard again, she's the only justice who voted back in November not to hear a challenge to Prop 8 once it was passed. Of course, all of this is hugely controversial. We want to know what you think about the legal issues involved. Should the state Supreme Court have the ability to overturn a voter-approved initiative such as Proposition 8? You can vote online right now, KCRA.com. Drop us a note with your thoughts about this entire issue.